Hi everyone, I'm Katrine with the Girl Scouts of Wisconsin Badgerland. Thanks for coming by today. We are going to be learning about symmetry in nature. Now, what do hearts, snowflakes, and butterflies have in common? Well, if you thought symmetry, boom, you were right. So symmetry is like a mirror image. It's when two parts look exactly the same. Now think of our face. If we drew a line down the middle of our face, you could see that the left and the right mirror each other. That's symmetry. And this line that you see where you can make a fold, that is the line of symmetry. Now, different objects in nature are symmetrical, and some of them are bilateral symmetry. Now, bilateral means two-sided symmetry. So think about your face, right? Think about a butterfly or a heart. If you were to put a line of symmetry right down the middle, you'd be able to fold it and each side would be exactly the same. Now, there are also some objects in nature that are symmetrical, but not bilateral. They have many different ways that you can fold, like a spider web or a snowflake. But for today, we are going to be doing bilateral symmetry by creating a butterfly. So here's what you're going to need. You will need two wire hangers, two large pieces of tissue paper, two pipe cleaners, some coloring supplies, white craft glue, and scissors. Now, optional, you can also have some stickers or some glitter or other really fun art materials to decorate your bilateral symmetrical butterfly. So here, let's get started. First, you're going to take your wire hanger, hold it right side up. So hook up, long side down. You're going to go ahead and take that hook and start bending it as best you can. Now get a grown up if you need it, okay? Go ahead and bend that hook down towards the shoulder and just start to look like a little antenna. That's going to be the antenna of the butterfly. Take your other hanger, bend it again, bend that hook down towards the shoulder as best you can. And it's okay if the wire gets a little wonky. Well, they're pliable. That means they're really flexible and like to get bent and are easily maneuverable back. Okay, so we have one antenna, two antennas. Now remember, symmetrical, right? If you fold it down the middle, it'll look the same on both sides. So what we're going to do is our best to make this symmetrical. Now, here are the two antennas, and here is the body. Now, what you're going to do is you're gonna take one of your pipe cleaners and wrap it around really well, so that the butterfly body is attached together. Be careful, the wire hangers can get a little out there. All right, just wrap it all the way down the body, keep it tight so that it won't come apart. There we go. Then you're gonna maneuver this out a little bit to make further the body. And you can see it's little bend here, little hooks. So what you wanna do is keep moving it around to straighten out. Put it down if you have to. Sometimes it's a bit hard to do it in the air, and that's okay. Take your other pipe cleaner and really tighten up right underneath. Okay, it's okay if it gets a little wonky again. It can tend to move around a bit, and that's okay. But I'm just gonna do my best to get the pipe cleaners all around and wrapped so that these two hangers are really affixed together. Now, we have the body of the butterfly already. We have our antennas, and now we just need to make the wings. So holding your butterfly, just pull out the wire hanger to make the wings the shape that you want. So I'm just holding on to it and I'm pulling the body. See that? Here we go. So here are our two antennae and here are our wings. Now, symmetrical. Can I fold it? And they look exactly the same. Not quite. So I'm gonna eagle eye this a little bit. I'm gonna make sure that this generally looks the same. This is mirroring each other. My bottom wings are mirroring each other and my outer wings are mirroring. Outer part of my wing mirroring the other. So just do your best to make them look symmetrical. So each side is about the same. Good, and it's okay if it does a little bit of a wiggle. If you have another pipe cleaner, you can always keep going all the way down the body and making sure that it's all nicely wrapped. Okay, here are my butterfly wings. What you're going to do next is take your white glue and you're going to, with your finger, put some glue on your finger and you're going to just outline one of the wings in blue and put it on tissue paper. So what I'm gonna do first is put my tissue paper down on a flat table. I'm going to take my wings and take my glue, put some glue on my finger, and I'm going to just outline one side of my wings. Get a little gloopy, and that's okay. And as I'm doing that, I'm looking at my piece of tissue paper that I know is going to be half my wing. Now when you have glue all over one side, go ahead and lay it flat on your tissue paper. Then put glue on your finger again and put glue on the other side of the wing. Right. And then you're going to put the tissue paper right on the other side, make it flat. It's going to catch on that glue. If you need a little bit more glue, go ahead and put some more glue on there. Here you can see I've put glue on both sides of the hanger and I have placed my tissue paper on both sides. So now it's holding, it's gonna dry a little bit. Now as I wait for it to dry, I'm going to put glue on the other side so that I can put tissue paper on the other side. All right, once I got glue there, the only thing that you're not going to do is put glue on the antenna. That's what you're going to try to watch. Don't put it on the antenna. The antenna doesn't need tissue paper or glue. They're going to stay out there. How's everyone doing at home? Hopefully getting nice and gluey and messy and really excited about what your butterfly is going to look like. Okay, so I have my tissue paper on my butterfly. Gonna let it dry on my second side. I'm gonna go back to my first side and gently trim away the excess tissue paper. I would leave a little space so you can see. I'm gonna cut along the side of the hanger of the wing, but leave a little bit of space here should I want to just glue it a little bit more. this is the moment you'll probably see where some glue is stronger and some needs some extra glue, and that's cool. Not bad if I say so. All right, I'm gonna take my glue and I'm going to go ahead and add more glue where I see some spots that could use some extra stick on that tissue paper. Glue that down. When you're finished, you should have a bilateral symmetrical butterfly. Now take your coloring supplies, your markers, your paints, your colored pencils, stickers, your glitter, and you can decorate your butterfly in any way that you'd like. Remember, you want to make them symmetrical, so mirror images on either side. So whatever decoration that you decide to do on one side, make sure you do it on the other side too. Ta-da! I'm going to go ahead and get my glitter and my stickers as I make my beautiful symmetrical butterfly. You go grab your stuff, and I hope you had a really good time. Don't forget to show your family and your friends your beautiful butterfly when it's fully done. And also share with them what it means to be symmetrical and why a butterfly is symmetrical. And you can even demo it with the wings. So thank you so much for being here. I hope you had fun. You can continue on with your activities at Girl Scouts at Home. Again, I'm Katrine with the Girl Scouts of Wisconsin Badgerland, and happy adventuring and Girl Scouting out there. Thanks for joining me. Bye.